This video describes the different developmental stages of microsporangia as we discussed in our previous sessions. So these will be a group of cells called as microsporangial initials. They are going to undergo the division leading to formation of upper as well as lower. Upper is called as primary wall cells, whereas lower is primary sporogenous cells. The primary wall cell led to formation of the 3 to 6 layers of the wall. Here it is like 1, 2, 3, 4 layers of the wall, and inner tissue it is going to form a mass called as sporogenous tissue. The outermost layer of the sporogenous tissue differentiate into a nutritive layer called as stapedom, and these rest cells of the sporogenous tissue, they will utilize this nutrition and they are going to develop into spore mother cell or microspore mother cells. These are undergo meiotic division leading to formation of the spore tetrads. There is four haploid four haploid spores are formed. Outermost layer of this wall is called as epidermis. This is how the developed microsporangium looks like. It may be having a stalk of some multicellular, or the stalk may be absent and it is directly attached to the microsporophyll. In that case, we are going to call it as an sessile form. And these are the different stages in the development of the microsporangium. Now looking at the female reproductive organ. So this is the image of the female reproductive organ in case of cycas. The female reproductive organ are called as megasporophylls. Each female plant every year produces numerous megasporophylls. What are megasporophylls? You can make out here. These are the leaf, somewhat light brown to golden color. These are all single leaves. These leaves are called as megasporophylls. These megasporophylls are produced in an acropetal succession above each crown. So we have a crown here. In the center of a crown, we can see these megasporophylls. What's the difference between a male and the female reproductive organ in case of cycas is, male reproductive organ is somewhat cone shaped as we saw, because their microsporophyll are going to form a compact structure. Even those are the leaves only, they are arranged compactly to form that cone like structure. Here these leaves called as megasporophyll, they won't form the compact structure, they are loosely arranged. That's the reason there is no cone, female cone in case of cycas. Centrally we have these megasporophylls which are arranged loosely, and it appears like a rosette in the center of the crown of these foliage leaves. These megasporophylls are much more in number. If you are going to count these green color foliage leaves, these megasporophylls are much more in number compared to these green leaves. They are not compactly arranged, they are loosely present at the center of the crown of these leaves. It gives the appearance of a rose-like structure, so we call it as a rosette in appearance. So this was like a female reproductive organ, which is not a cone at all. Thank you.